together in my comic strip. Let's talk in bubbles, let's go.
Bang!
And forget your travels and go.
Shabam! Pow! Blop! Whee!
I'm the hero, and when I am fighting, I go. So,
shabam, pow, bloop, whee!
Come with me, let's get together in my comic strip. Let's talk in bubbles, let's go.
Bang!
And forget your troubles and go.
Shabam, pow, bloop, whee!
If you want to fly above the city, follow me.
Film, and it's not going to be my last. Regardless of whether or not this one gets picked up or no one ever sees it again, I'm going to wake up tomorrow morning and be a filmmaker. That's who I am.
Well, you certainly chose a filmmaker's film. It's been hailed as a contemporary remake of the critically renowned 1967 classic Bonnie and Clyde, with a twist. Did you tackle this project because it tells the audience who you are?
Well, when I made the final cut, I realized that this film ended up showing way more than the idea I started with, and that represents not just who I am, but who you are and who everyone is.
I thought the acting was well done for a low-budget film.
Yes, it was. Of course, as director, I take full credit for that. I'm joking.
How would you describe the experience of working with amateur actors?
Well, first of all, I would never call them that to their face. You know, you're likely to have one flip out on you or something. I must say I have been lucky, though.
How's that?
I think it has a lot to do with the fact that I'm essentially an actor's director.
What the fuck was that?
What?
Look, John, buddy, you nailed that line. I'm sweating.
Barbara,
how should I put this? I'm just gonna need more here, okay? More. Yeah. So what we're gonna do is, Jesus, what is that smell? Which one of you produced that? How can you concentrate?
That smell is coming from her.
Barbara.
Come on, it smelled so bad I almost gagged in the middle of my line.
Oh, okay, I know what you guys are thinking. I did
Joe,
not.
Can we get a fan on Barbara, please? ASAP?
Why don't you take that fan and shove it up your ass? Cause I quit.
Barbara, come on. Look, don't get all defensive. This is the last scene we have to shoot. You can't throw a fit now.
Ian, I'm gonna be honest with you. You suck, and I'm never working with you again. The only reason I took this job was because everyone knows that you're friends with Curtsy McDowell. And I guess maybe I thought that this job would be my lucky break. And about halfway through the shoot, not only did I realize this is not my lucky break, but it's the worst thing I've ever been a part of. I'm not gonna meet Curtsy McDowell, and he's not even gonna see this piece of shit.
Yeah, he's not, because I'm not friends with him. That's just a stupid rumor, and if that's the only reason you took the job, well, then maybe you should...
You're just jealous because he has more talent in his middle initial than you'll ever have.
Barbara, come on.
Ciao, baby.
Shit. Now what?
Oh. Well, guys, I guess that's it. Sorry there was no food today.
Wait, what do you mean that's it? We have one more scene left to shoot, not to mention a crucial scene in the film.
No, just stop, okay? Barbara quit tonight, okay? She's gone. It's raining outside. We have to get the equipment back by morning. There's no more money. I'll have to edit around it.
What? And have it come out looking like the Blair Witch Project? Have some dignity, for God's sake. You do that and I'll take my name out of the credits. You will not see John Hancock's name in the credits, no way.
Got any bright ideas?
Yeah. Fuck Barbara. We do this right here, right now.
Oh yeah, right here, right now, huh? Who's gonna say Barbara's lines?
What the hell went wrong? What could I have done? Everything that could have got fucked up did get fucked up in some way or another. And I know it's my fault. I know it's my fault. But don't you say anything, you miserable. It is your fault. And you can never take it back. Never. Don't cry, Bonnie. You know how it just breaks my heart when you do that. That hurt, Bonnie. That hurt. I reckon it did, Clyde. It was supposed to. And I'm leaving now.
Fuck. Fucking amateurs. And that's really the key to working with actors in independent films. You can't let them give up. They'll want to, believe me. But, sometimes push comes to shove when you're trying to get an indie film made.
Let's talk about the scene where Clyde, played by John Hancock, has a schizophrenic breakdown in his car. It's scenes like that that gives characters three-dimensional, dimensions. What inspires the kind of mindset it takes to create such a scene?
In that particular scene, I was really going for something that had never been done before. At least not to my knowledge. No. I wanted to portray a sympathetic anti-hero, and I worked very hard so that the symbolism would speak for itself. This is why I work within the smaller independent community. We're doing things that haven't been done before. I certainly wasn't thinking of critics, namely Jane Muir, when I made this film.
So Jane Muir hasn't seen the movie yet?
Film. Please, call it a film.
She hasn't reviewed the film yet.
Please don't talk about love tonight. Please don't talk about sweet love. Please don't talk about being true and all the trouble we've been through. Oh, please don't talk about all the plans we had for fixing this broken romance. I want to go where the people dance. I want some action. I want to live. Action. I got so much to give. I want to give it. I want to get some too.
So then the rabbi says, we're gonna like this.
Dude, there she is.
Oh. Should I introduce myself? Maybe I should offer her something to eat.
No.
Hi.
Dude, just watch where she sits so we can check out her reaction to the film.
Horchata? No, we don't have that here.
Oh. You have corn nuts?
Did she just ask for corn nuts?
No, thanks. I'm working right now. Maybe later.
You're awfully cute.
Oh, thank you.
Cheers.
Yeah, cheers.
Just asking.
Sorry.
Hey, can we get you guys to move over a couple of seats?
No.
Can you see her?
Yeah. These seats are golden. We got her covered.
can't take this. I'm gonna say something.
No, you know. You gotta be careful. I don't wanna get on her bad side.
Oh, and throwing popcorn in her hair was a good idea? So, how'd you like it? I'm the director, Ian Lester. Hey, I think I know what the problem was.
You're not listening to me. It's a blessing. This way she cannot give it a bad review. The film will not be trashed by Jane Muir. How can you argue with that?
Yes, she can't give it a bad review because she can't give it a review at all. Period. No one's gonna read about it in the paper. No one's gonna hear about it on TV. Nobody's even gonna see it. God, my life is like one long recurring nightmare.
So no one's gonna read about how Jane Muir thought the movie sucked and how it was too violent and how the characters didn't sing any songs. Did she really expect her to like it?
I mean, she could have. My point is that any press is good press, and a bad review is better than no review at all.
Then why does every indie filmmaker that she trashes mysteriously fall off the face of the earth? Look at what happened to Johnny Gobbs.
Johnny Gobbs got ripped and took a walk up a roof, all right? Say whatever you want, man. I have a bad feeling about this.
No, Miss Muir hasn't fully experienced my film yet. Although all the feedback I have gotten has been extremely positive. Well, the critics really haven't seen anything like this since, so... Easy Rider? So, I'm expecting nothing less than four boas when she finally does get the chance to see it.
Speaking of which, rumor has it that a distribution for Bonnie and Clyde is in the works with a major distribution company. Can you comment on that?
You've done your homework. Kudos. No, unfortunately, I can't give any details at the time. I will say I'm in meetings with a certain company as we speak.
Well, that's great news. I think everyone should have the chance to see your film on the big screen. Tell me, did your friend Kurt C. McDowell pull some strings to get you into these negotiations?
This interview's over.
You black bastard.
Forget it. Hey, let's have a drink.
You're drinking too much.
Ian!
Why don't you and I have a drink?
Excuse me, Ian, did I say something offensive?
What?
I didn't realize I was going to offend you with that question.
Sorry, I can't hear you. I have to go now. Just have your people...
What people? Sensitive prick.
Check it out, sweet premium. See me, I'm chilling like the maniacal villain that I am. Full of scams, my kind of jam, buddy pal. See, first name Al, last name Keyhole, like I never fill my toilet with guts. What's up while they shut down? You'll a butt score for. If I had a dime for every quarter last year, I paid some old dude to get beer from me from 7-Eleven, 7 Crew. Mad whole crew say, fuck some my DA rap.
Try to get something to eat, man.
Oh, man. I'm sorry. I don't have anything to give you, man.
Me?
I don't have anything, man. I'm sorry.
You got that beer? I'll take that.
Come on, man. You don't need my beer.
I'll change your mind. Who that? It's God of the West Coast.
Give me the phone, man. Dude, I'm waiting for a call.
No supreme being.
You want the beer? Take my drink. Here, take this. Hello? Ian Lester here, hello?
Ian, is that you?
Yeah. Matt, what's up, man?
It's Matthew. I only let the big client.
Well, then I guess I'll be calling you Matt in a couple weeks from now, right? How was the meeting?
Tell me what happened.
How was the interview?
Don't fuck around, man. I just spent my last buck on a beer I had to give to some bum. Just tell me what happened.
Well, remember when we talked about best and worst case scenarios?
Yeah.
Okay, throw all that shit out the window.
What? Dude, I said don't jerk me off.
I'm your agent. It's my job to jerk you off.
Okay, all I want to know is, am I getting distribution or not?
Oh, the answer is yes and no. See, the Epsteins have committed to opening the film as a limited release, meaning not quite as many theaters as we had hoped for, and... not as long a run as we had asked for.
Well, that's kind of fucked up, but I guess I can live with it. What exactly does limited mean? Like,
Are we talking about a couple hundred screens instead of 1,000, or...?
Well, see, that's the thing. If it does well in its initial release, meaning we can show that people are definitely interested in your movie, we'll get that kind of distribution.
Like multiplexes in BFE.
BFE? What are you talking about? No, I want to talk about the deal as it stands. What's the release and how long?
One theater, one night.
That's the deal? Oh, that is one hell of a deal, Monty. You call yourself an agent?
Look, that's the deal. Take it or leave it. This is the fucking Epstein brothers we're talking about here. You know how many guys would kill to be in your position right now?
They like the film.
And they want to release it wide, but they have to ensure a return on their investment.
But, they really like the film, huh?
How do I know? I don't even think they like movies. Look, you got bigger things to worry about right now. The movie's running this Friday at the Bridge, right? And we gotta get people in those seats.
Do you have any funding for advertising?
Oh yeah, you didn't see the big billboard over Union Square? Matthew, I'm talking to you on a payphone right now because my phone was disconnected 3 months ago.
Well, it looks like we're gonna have to rely on the review, amigo. Which can be a poor filmmaker's best friend.
Yeah, or the kiss of death.
Like that attitude. Are you familiar with Jane Muir?
Ah, yeah, she showed up for the screening at the Khakis Are Cool festival.
And?
And? Have you ever seen somebody asleep sitting straight up with their eyes open?
I've seen cows do it, but what do you mean?
Well, let's just say a cattle prod wouldn't disturb that heifer.
Classic Muir. Not to worry, I've got this one covered.
Tourne toi.
Oh, take that. You think you're naughty. I'll show you naughty, cowboy. Oh, you want to eat me all up? Wow, I haven't heard that one yet. Ooh, you want to feel my skin against your leather chaps. Okay, how does this sound? No. Oh, that's too bad. You like that? Well, how about I play the bull and you play the young, tough, Marlboro-smoking bull rider? Oh, yeah. Whoa! You are a real frontiersman. Aw, you're gonna leave me all hot and bothered, huh? All right, I'll get you back for that one. Bye-bye, cowboy 69.
You too, Mom. Yeah, I know it's been a while, but I might have some time off coming up here.
I got a deal. Yeah, the rabbits are fine, Mom. I fed them this morning. This morning, yeah. So, are they treating you good in there? You making friends? Huh? Movies? Yeah, I'm still making movies, Mom. I'll call you the next free minute they give me. Right, love you too. The rabbits are fine, right. Okay, bye-bye now. Love you. John, sorry to wake you up, man. I know it's late, but just listen, let me crash at your pad tonight. Hello? John?
How are the rabbits, Ian?
Do you have one night?
Comment vont les lapins, Ian?
Do you have one night? I'm coming for you.
You are so goddamn stupid.
Get up before I promise why I'm coming to get you. Get up one theater one night.
Tu es vraiment stupide, mon pauvre.
Wake up
one theater one night.
Get up one theater one night.
We gotta go to work. Do you remember you got a day job, right, champ?
Shut the fuck up.
Hey, get the fuck up. Gotta go to work soon. Looks like you haven't seen a shower in days.
Dreaming in cliches. Sleep without me.
Oh, I'll catch up later.
All right, big shot. Whatever.
Wait! I'm coming. Just fucking wait a minute.
Computer cheats.
John, please, I did a 13 and a 14th. Are you gonna do the 30s or you wanna start?
I always do the 30s. I did them yesterday. Give them to Ian.
Why are you changing your shirt again? You change your shirt every day. What are you, this man on television, this Mr. Roger?
That shirt's bad luck. I need this one to beat mine sweet.
In my country, there is no such thing as bad luck.
Yeah, I knew you were gonna say that. All you French girls are the same.
So this is 216?
Who?
Ian! Did he still want the 6? Because I was going to not do them. Is he still having his crush on Mademoiselle?
Mademoiselle?
Mademoiselle? Is that what you're calling yourself these days, Hancock?
Ouch. Good one, Craig.
Yeah. Look, tell Lester I need to see him right away about some outgoing that didn't get picked up yesterday. Can you do that for me, Hancock?
Sure thing, Craig. Isn't that the second time this week?
Yep.
Okay, guy. So, what were we talking about? Mademoiselle?
Oui, you know this blonde called Laetitia on 6? The one with the long legs?
Yeah, the cream puff. I think he still likes her. He gets weird every time I bring her up.
What is cream puff?
Forget it. Yeah, give him the 6, but I'm still not doing the 30s.
What is it you're going to do then?
I don't know. I'll just sort.
Where is it that Ian has been? I've not seen him for an hour.
He's going through some stuff right now.
Stuff?
Maybe he's in the shitter.
What is shitter?
You know, the WC, the bathroom.
What is Ian's problem?
To controller to destino.
What does this mean?
To controller to destino.
What is he talking about?
How am I supposed to know? I don't speak Spanish. Leave me alone.
You know, it means you have the 30s to do. Yeah. And I saved the 6 for you special today, Romeo. You better hurry up before lunch break.
Oh, Juliet. I'm gonna open the mail up all over you.
Oh, Leticia, tes lettres sont très douces, chaudes.
Hey, Jason. I wanted to talk to you about something. Hello? Hello? Mail guy?
Oh, hey, what's up?
Hi. Is there any way that the people in AP can get our mail, like, the day it gets here? You know, the company shouldn't be paying bills late. I've emailed Craig Newcomb about this several times, and he assured me you guys could handle it.
Hey, Amy.
Maybe not.
Amy, is the mail guy up to speed on today's mail issues?
Yeah.
Great.
Finally.
And Dan Yo-Yo is waiting for a priority letter that was supposed to be here yesterday. But no rush.
Hey, wanna go get a yum and smooth?
Definitely.
It's easy for you to say, jackass. Fucking mail boy. Oh my back. Fucking mail boy.
I don't know who he was calling mail boy. He ran into me.
You know the mail boy?
No, I deliver the mail, yes, but I'm no boy.
Oh, okay. So what is it you'd like to be called then?
Actually I prefer postal expediter. It sounds less trivial. Although, Ian works also.
But you do deliver mail.
Yeah, but I have to sort it, too. This is just my day job anyway. I've got other stuff going on. I won't have to do this menial labor crap much longer, believe me. Although it does have its perks, such as, meeting pretty ladies like yourself. Yeah, that and running people over with the mail cart. Well, here's your mail.
This is not mine, this mail I told you yesterday. This person sits right over there.
Oh, right. Well, then, I guess I'll see you tomorrow. Leticia, is it? Okay, hasta luego.
So I say to Penn, look, Sean, wrecked him. I nearly killed him.
What is wrecked him?
Hey, here's one theater one night.
Hey, big guy. I was just telling your coworkers here about the time I did the guest spot on Nash Bridges.
Please tell me this unannounced visit means good news.
Of course it does. I don't do face-to-face for bad news, my good man. I'm gonna go somewhere we can talk, take a walk.
No. He still has the studies to do.
What?
Oh, look, Sabine.
No.
Oh, come on. I never ask you for favors. Just this one time. Please.
Right, go with your friend, your time.
Let's go. So it's a meeting or a lunch?
Well, it's both. It's what we call a power lunch. We're gonna sit, talk, eat, and go over future developments. Ours and hers, if you know what I mean.
No, I don't know what you mean. Thought I was clear on that.
Okay. First I'm gonna bullshit with her like I care. I'm gonna ask about our mutual friends, how our stocks are doing, you know, like regular bullshit. But as the conversation continues, I'm gonna be gradually, but furtively, hitting her weak spot. Then I'm gonna go for the throat with a ballpoint like Pesci in Casino. I'm gonna offer goods, complimentary to Epstein's, in exchange for favors. So by the time the check comes, she's gonna be writing our ticket to the distribution deal, the nationwide deal. Euro market, primetime spots on Mexican TV.
Love this job. Wait a minute. So, what I'm getting out of this is, we're gonna bribe Jane Muir, like some port city hooker, in order to get my film, a film she's never even seen before, a good review, and you think that's gonna get us to deal with the Epsteins?
What about the Khakis or Cool Festival?
No, I already told you, man, she slept through the whole thing.
At least she showed up. She's a critic. You think they see every movie they review? Relax, sit tight. I'm the pro here. If you let me handle this, make you one happy mail boy.
That's a postal expediter to you.
I will be filmmaker, if you let me handle this, ex-bialidocious.
Hi. Party of two, Skinner?
You know, go ahead and pick any table you want. The other half of your party's been in the bar for about an hour.
Woo! Hey, Paul, let's get another round over here!
The old guy who won the lottery last week's giving it away to children's charities.
Really?
No. Nobody's that fucking stupid. It does say that someone's already purchased the rights to his story, though. Probably for a TV miniseries or something.
Cool.
You know what sucks about this city?
Everything?
Come on. I mean, when you think of San Francisco, you think of this big metropolitan area and stuff, but when you're actually in it, it's pretty tiny.
How do you mean?
Like when I first moved here, I met all these new people, and that was cool, but now I keep running into the same people over and over again. It sucks.
Okay, who'd you see?
You remember that bitch Samantha that was staying at my crib last year? You know, the one with the big tits, speed freak, stole my cell phone when I threw her ass out?
Okay, right.
Right, last night I'm kicking it at the Sound Factory. I'm grooving, and I run into her. Fucking don't even recognize her at first. She's got red hair now.
Really?
Yeah, and she's all like, oh my God, how are you? Like nothing ever happened.
No way.
Right as I'm stepping to this hottie, too. Fucking scared her away. Still got at the hottie a little later, though. I gave her my number.
Wait, later? Like, you mean you stayed after the whole Sabrina incident?
Samantha, I didn't really stay. Let's just say I went back in after I got done pumping her in the parking lot.
Ah, Sean.
Nah, dude, she looks good. She's not on crank anymore. She only does E now.
Huh.
Yeah, but the fucked up thing is this. She stole my cell phone again, and that's the number I gave to the hottie. Oh, great, another breakout of E. coli.
Just have one, man. It'll make you feel better. I haven't seen you eat a thing since this whole deal shit started.
Whole deal shit?
Yeah, I know why you're not eating. Your stomach's all fucked up because of the distribution thing.
Oh, that. Nah, I wasn't even really thinking about it.
Is it because the repo man came and carted off your scooter this morning?
No. It's nothing. I'm just not hungry.
Oh, I know that not hungry. That's a special I'm not hungry. That's the I'm not hungry because I saw Leticia today and I didn't get the chance to rub one out yet. Dude, face it, it's all backed up into your stomach. No wonder you're not hungry.
Shut the fuck up.
Lie to me and tell me you didn't talk to her today.
Talk to her?
And?
And what?
Man, you're gonna beat around the bush for weeks like you always do. She's either gonna get a boyfriend or her visa's gonna expire and you're gonna be shit out of luck like always. Sitting around your shitty ass apartment at night thinking about her. Like you guys actually had something and then you'll be calling me up to complain.
I said shut the fuck up.
Well, then what happened when you gave her the mail?
I talked to her. At least I tried to talk to her. I don't know, man. Her accent just makes me feel like I'm a kid. Just makes me feel like I'm back in grade school trying to ask a girl to dance. In a way, that's what makes it a challenge, but I can't come up with something witty to say like usual. And I can't, you know, talk about filmmaking and flex my intellectual side like usual. I don't even think she understands half the funny shit I say. And, well, let's face it, there's only so much I know about Alain Delon and, like, Water for Chocolate or whatever. So anyway, I give her the package and she says...
Ian? Ian?
I want to hear what they're saying about me.
So anyway, I think I'm going to buy now while it's down because it's only going to rebound in another year. So how are your stocks doing?
Oh, has anyone ever told you you're the most boring person in the whole world to listen to?
I think that was you who told me that the last time we spoke.
Oh, <woo-hoo. laughs>
Oh, sounds like somebody needs another drink. Ooh. Maybe a tequila?
Hmm. Oh, yeah. This would be the part where you would ask me about a family member or a mutual friend.
So, you think you know the name of the game, huh? You don't know my game. I'll bet that you don't know what I'm going to say next.
Oh, please. All you fat guys are all the same. You're always trying to squeeze somebody for something.
Where's that drink?
Oh, what you drinking?
What? But forget it. I've got to go, okay?
Okay. I'm sorry. Come on, I know you invited me to lunch for a reason.
Moi, je pense que tu vas bien l'aimer.
Ouais.
C'est bien pour toi de sortir de temps en temps.
T'as besoin d'en finir avec Jean-Jean.
En fait, il me fait penser à Emmett Bondo.
Oui?
Oh mon Dieu, c'est Jean-Jean, ça va ça? Il serait dans ce colère. Ouh là là, terrible.
So what they say, Encyclopedia Brown?
I don't know. It sounded really good, though. But I don't think they're speaking English.
Let's see. Sabine is French, and I'm pretty sure that Leticia is French.
You know French.
I took it in high school. It doesn't count.
I know they're talking about me.
Hey, Paul! Get this man another drink. And another one for me while you're at it, huh?
So I say to Sean, look, pen, wrecked him. I nearly killed him.
Make his a double. Wait, make them both doubles.
Were you going to get down to business? Or are you just going to sweet talk me all night, huh?
Now, the Epstein brothers are willing to generously compensate you. Nothing like last time. For at least an optimistic review of an upcoming film.
All right. Which one of their B-grade films do they want me to tongue-in-cheek this time?
Come on. I know you didn't entirely hate Mr. Smith Goes Back to Washington. You even said, and I quote, funnier than a ride through Chinatown.
Ah!
So don't act like this is a bribe.
Oh, well, you know what? This one better be better than Mr. Smith Goes Back to Washington. Or I might not be so open-handed next time.
You've seen it already.
Yeah?
At the Khakis Are Cool Festival, a night screening.
Yeah?
It was the remake of an American classic, with a twist.
Il n'est pas un de ces types qui distribuera du courrier pour toujours. Il fait des films. Il aime les films.
Ouais. Je pense que c'est romantique. Mm-hmm. Mais il a l'air d'un type timide. Tu sais que je n'aime pas ce genre.
Non, mais il n'est pas timide avec moi, pas du tout. Il me fait rire. Parfois, il me dit la manière dont il va devenir célèbre et riche, et moi, je serai son personal French maid. C'est bête.
Ouais.
What are they saying, man?
Dude, they're saying that you're funny and romantic, and that you're gonna be famous.
Yeah?
Je ne sais pas. Je ne peux pas me voir avec un courrier garçon. Même s'il est mignon et doué. Dis-moi quelque chose. As-tu eu ce courrier garçon? Jamais. Mais oui, bien sûr. C'est la seule chose que nous faisons toute la journée. C'est rouler nu dans ton courrier.
Je le savais. J'ai toujours dit que tu valais ce mon 33 centimes belge.
Première classe, salope.
Non, mais je pense qu'il est sérieux au sujet du film.
Ouais.
Tu sais, il est ami avec Curtis McDowell.
I heard Curtis McDowell. What are they saying?
What are you talking about?
I heard Curtis McDowell. What, do they think I look like him?
What's your complex? You're hearing shit.
Come on, man. What are they saying?
You're gonna jinx yourself. Listen to me. It's all good for you so far. Chill out.
D'accord. Je vais lui donner un essai.
Ouais.
Je sortirai avec lui, s'il me demande. Moi, je ferai sûr qu'il te demande.
Ouais.
Je dois faire attention tout de même.
Dude, you're so in. She wants you to ask her out.
Pourquoi dois-tu faire attention au sujet de laisser un garçon connaître mes sentiments? Il y a quelque chose que tu me caches, hein? Te marier?
Non. Mais on doit le garder en secret.
En secret?
Peut-être si tu sais pas ceci, mais le bizarre a quelque chose pour toi.
Bizarre? Quel est bizarre?
Le bizarre est Ian. Et ton mignon, c'est John.
Hey, I heard your name. What's going on? Are they talking about you now?
Oh, they're just talking about some other shit now.
Right. Come on. I'm going in. This is the perfect time for me to make my move.
Whoa there, Tiger. It's way too soon. You don't want to jump the gun and get caught off guard. You might think it's way too coincidental that they were just talking about you, and then you magically appear. You might get labeled a stalker.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Stalker?
Never mind. Come on, let's go.
All right, I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna write 2 reviews of a new Epstein film. The first review is gonna pack the asses in the theater seats by the truckloads. But the second one, it's gonna put the poster on the video store window by the end of the week. This is what you are gonna do. You are gonna wait for my instructions via email. I don't know what it is exactly that I want. But let's just say our ideas of generous compensation aren't exactly what I call in sync. You'll get my message by the end of the day. And I better get yours by morning. And if I get it and I'm pleased, review numero uno gets the green light. But if I don't get it, big guy, or I'm not impressed, then review numero B. Start your engines!
Let me give you my personal email address. I need to get this message ASAP. I'm working on a deadline here, okay?
Are you gonna finish that? What?
Yeah, I don't want to wait too long, though, because once my film comes out, she's going to see me totally different because of all the attention and money and everything. Yeah, I think I should definitely go for it today, while she still sees me as Ian the mailboy and not, you know, Ian the film director. I want our relationship to be genuine, not based on my success.
Wait a second there, Hasselhoff. With Letitia, maybe you should go on a few dates before you start using words like genuine and relationship. And as far as this film thing's concerned, maybe you should wait till it comes out before you start acting like Kevin Bacon.
I don't understand. What you told me back there about what the girl said, that was exactly what I needed to get my confidence up. I mean, first you're telling me it's all good, then you throw me this curveball. You're not making sense. What the hell should I do?
Listen, the shy guy thing's working. I heard Letitia and she likes the shy guy. Now the fact that you're awkward, that's a big turn on. The last thing a woman like that wants is some silver-tongued French-speaking American guy that just wants to get her to-
Fuck!
Learn how to walk!
Look, that car almost hit those guys. Ed, that's John!
That's a weird one.
Yeah, I guess he's supposed to be some kind of masochist or something. I heard he started that whole gerbil in the ass rumor by himself, just like to try to end his own career.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that just got him more attention. Then he lands a 3-picture deal with Disney. Mm-hmm. Right, oh, and then he tried to commit fashion suicide by styling the 84 Don Johnson peppered mullet.
Okay, that's crazy.
I know. I mean, name one other non-British actor with a string of bombs so long that's still making shitty pictures.
Come on, let's go.
So then he even did a military/romance drama and got away with it.
Who are we talking about again?
Come on, man, you know who I'm talking about. Mr. Goodbar himself.
So anyway, he's pretty cool though. I think I'm gonna send him a copy of my new shit. Actually, I think he'd be perfect opposite the Olsen twins.
Wait a second, who are we talking about again? Are you trying to do a remake of American Gigolo?
Meets Parent Trap 2, I think. Wait, fuck.
Just the mademoiselle I wanted to see.
Oh no, this is not about Ian again, is it?
Not exactly. It's like that little white trash kid from Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. He's getting bribed to give up the everlasting gobstopper by some creepy dude. And on one hand, he's got the chance to make some serious cash and help out the house full of alcoholic relatives he has to support. And in the other hand, he has the gobstopper and the promise he made to Willy. What does he do? He says fuck Willie's rich ass and goes for the chance to make some serious cash and fix his fucked up home life, right?
Right. Ian is the little white trashy boy?
Exactly. Listen. I overheard you and Letitia at lunch today. I couldn't help it. I wanted to see if I could still understand French, and I can. And I heard everything.
Oh, really? And what is it that we said?
Well, the short format is that Letitia likes me and not Ian, and that you think it'd be a good way for her to get over her ex-boyfriend, Jean-Luc Picard.
Jean-Jean?
Yeah, whatever. The point is that for some asinine reason, Ian thinks that Letitia likes him.
And why is this?
I don't know. That's just Ian, I guess. But despite his eccentric qualities, he is my friend, and although the allure of a hot French babe is very appealing, I just couldn't do that to Ian. At least not now.
But she like you, she don't like him. I don't understand why he can't be okay with this. He does not have to know.
It's a bit more complicated than that.
Men in France are not like this. If a girl like a man, and the man
like
want
I said,
her,
the situation is beyond fucked up. This me and Letitia thing, it can't happen. We cannot be together.
Look, she told me she was interested. She did not say for a relationship, though.
Even still, I just don't think I could look Ian in the face every day.
La la, John, you make things so complicated.
You're a star, right? You're a star. You're big, bright, shiny. What's up, dude?
Hey, Sabine, spell I cup.
I cup? I-C-U-P? What? What is funny? Ian, someone was here earlier looking for you. He looked really serious.
Was it a reporter? John?
I'm pretty sure it was another creditor looking to garnish your wages.
Yeah, all right. Sabine, can you do me a favor?
Yes, I will cover for you again. But can you take Mr. Comedy American Stupid with you?
Thanks.
Oh, and Craig was looking for you, too.
I wouldn't say nervous. I've got too much other shit to worry about to be nervous.
That's good to hear. So, remind me, why'd you call again?
Are we, sleeping with the enemy?
What?
Come on, dude, you know what I'm talking about.
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, well, did she take the bride like a Port City hooker or what?
She knows what we have in mind. But speaking from a professional perspective, I wouldn't call it a bribe, and I'd appreciate it if you didn't either. It's almost impossible for any critic to view and review all the films that come out, so sometimes they need a little help.
What are you talking about, dude? She went to see my film and fell asleep.
She said she needed some time to think about it. I'm looking at the list of demands she sent me right now. Most of the stuff is no problem. We can come up with it tonight. Some of the stuff is a little more bizarre. Still, I don't see a problem with it. There is one thing.
Well, this is great news. Let it never be said that you aren't pound for pound the most suspect agent in the biz. So, what are the demands?
you know, read me the list.
First, a Napier purple boa. Second,
Alicia Bridges compact disc box set, the Polish import. Third, 4 cases of single serving sized cordials, preferably Cavassier. Fourth, a Betamax copy of Sidney Lumet's wonderful 1978 classic, The Wiz. Fifth, the hands-free motorized kitty litter shit shoveler, the as-seen-on-TV model. Sixth, a VHS copy of Spring Break, When Good Girls Go Bad. And seventh, lucky number 7, is the custom delivery service of all of the items above, surrendered to me by none other than the fortunate Mr. Matthew Skinner. Time and place? The Monterey Lounge in the lobby of the Sir Francis Drake Hotel, 12 noon.
Special delivery for a not-so-special lady. If it seems light, it's because a couple of things are still on order. Otherwise, you should be satisfied.
Oh, I'm sure. Anyway, it's just one thing I need right now. Here, have a drink. It's on me.
I've got a lot of shit to do today.
Exactly! I gotta be on TV in a couple hours. I gotta get prepped.
So we have a deal then?
Oh, what's your hurry? You have to have at least one drink with me before you go.
I've got to...
Oh, look! Our table's ready! Now I've ordered 2 of our favorite drinks and they're on their way. Just get over there, get your little ass comfy-wumpy in the chair, and I'll be right there. Attaboy!
That's it though. One drink.
And that represents who I am, who you are, and everyone is. Who I am, who you are, and who everyone is. What the fuck does that mean? Did you really say that? Please tell me you're misquoted. It sounds like something Kurt C. said at the Music Video Movie Awards.
What?
What? Look at you. You look like shit. Today's the day.
Is today the day?
Jesus Christ.
You haven't slept all night.
Hey, John, you know what I'm gonna miss most about this place? Well, actually, I was gonna say nothing, but the more I think about it, I think I'm really gonna miss the people, because you know, they're like normal people with regular lives, and it's kind of cool to be around them and talk about, you know, regular stuff. You know what I mean?
No.
Ian! You're Ian Lester, right?
Oh, yeah, and you're... Wait, don't tell me. You sit on the 14th floor. I do you all the time. Well, I mean,
I don't... It's Amy. Amy Kaufman from accounting.
Right.
Of course.
I just wanted to say congratulations. When the email went out this morning about you and your little movie, me and Tamara were like, oh my god! The guy that delivers mail is a movie star! We had to hurry and get a copy of the paper to have you sign before you get all famous and quit. Lucky for us, there are a bunch left.
There was an email?
Could you make this out to Tamara?
Sure.
Cool.
Cool, yeah.
I can't believe I know somebody who knows Kurt C. McDowell.
Thanks for your support now. Take care now. You know, I had the same thing happen to me twice on the way in today.
Bastard, why'd you even come in today?
I gotta pick up my date for tonight.
You have a date?
Not yet, I just got here. Give me some time.
What do you mean?
Where's Sabine? I'll tell you when I get back.
Check 30 or 31. Look, I'm really an actor's director.
Bottoms up.
You always get peppered like this before TV reviews?
Prepped. I get prepped before my tapings. Gives me color.
Yeah, the lights do tend to make people look a little peaked. I would have thought your reason would be to calm the nerves.
Bah! Are you kidding? I'm professional. I don't need that.
I feel I was born in front of the camera.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I get that all the time. People think it's hard to be me. You know, smooth talker, always in control. But I guess we're all born with one special gift, right? Mine just happens to be PR.
Well, I'll drink to that. Of course, I'll drink to anything.
What?
What? You know what I like about this place? The great big rooms with the California Kings and the color TV. Oh, well, it's interesting you say that, because I just happen to have a key. And this key, it has a number on it. And somewhere on the fifth floor, there's a door with the same number on it. And I have a feeling, call it a hunch, that this key will unlock that door. What do you say? Cowboy.
No. I said C's B to C metrics, not gross seamless portals.
We're busy.
Oh la la, you scare me.
Sabine, sorry. Look, is everything still on for tonight?
Oh hey, I saw you on the paper. Congratulations. You are a big...
Yeah, big one. Listen, I just want to make sure you and Tisha still coming to the trapdoor tonight for drinks, you know, before the big...
Of course we're coming. We would not miss the big...
Oh God, Sabine, you've done me so many favors. I owe you big...
No, yeah, you don't owe me anything. Listen, I know how important this is to you, and I just want to let you know you should be quite proud. And however tonight turns out, we are all very proud of you. If your mother was here, it would be a big...
So, 5:30 at the trapdoor then, right?
Okay,
thanks, Sabine. I won't forget this.
Okay.
Amy Kaufman from accounting said she just saw him down here. Your lies aren't working on us, mailboy.
Amy who? Listen, I deliver to accounting. I've never heard of this Amy Hoffman person. This is starting to sound just like your imaginary hit-and-run incident.
All right, Hancock, that's enough. Is he here today or what?
There he is! There's a little prick who nearly killed me with his mail cart!
Lester, I've been looking for you. There's an issue that has been brought to my attention. Now, why don't the three of us
Craig, don't I even have a say in this?
Well, yes, of course. But sensitive matters should be discussed in private. So why don't the three of us...
Fire him! This kind of reprehensible behavior demands immediate, swift justice!
Look, me hitting you with the mail cart, that's an accident. Now, reprehensible behavior, that would be me, I don't know, telling you to go fuck yourself? Of course, I would never do that in the workplace.
Lester. You leave me with no other course of action but to terminate your employment.
You think I need this job? This job is yesterday's news. Read the paper, Chief. I'm today's news. Out of here. Today's the day! That's how today became the day, and that's why today is the motherfucking day!
Yeah! I'll see you in one night!
They call me. Oh, hey, everybody, this is my entourage. This is John the Knucklehead,
the lovely Sabine, and the absolutely stunning Leticia. Ooh. Hey, the ladies are off limits, pigs. They're French, and your World War II jokes won't work on them. They've heard them all before. Hey, guys, I'm really glad you came.
I hate you.
Why?
Because I cannot believe you told that little geek off when I was not even there.
Oh, that. Hey, how'd you like my exit?
Spectacular.
I haven't seen you today to tell you congratulations. I've seen you in the papers this morning. I couldn't believe that it is you.
Really? Why is that?
Hey, what was up with the peanut gallery when we walked in?
Just explaining what it takes to make a feature film. You know, all the long days, hard nights, all the stuff people just eat up. Excuse me for a second. Hey, I'm really glad you made it.
Yes, I'm really glad to see your movie. Jean's been telling me that it's really good.
Well, you'll find out tonight, since you have the best seat in the house. Right next to the ODA.
The ODA?
Yeah, you know the director? Me?
Ah, you mean Lotte? Ah, wait, well, yes. Watching the movie, should be a good time.
Well, I was thinking, we don't have to let the good times end there.
Yeah, all of us can go and get ice cream after the movie. I should sit down.
You know, Leticia, you have such beautiful eyes, you have to let me buy you a drink. Lloyd, we need two over here. What are you drinking? Wait, let me guess. Orangina and gin, right?
Okay.
Two corkscrews, please.
With an overwhelming majority of votes, the backing from America.
There'll be no charge to you, Mr. One Theater, One Night. Your money's no good here. Orders from the house.
That means a lot to me, Lloyd.
Analysts say that the impact on traffic should be minimal.
Well, salute. So, Leticia, how do you like your French toast in the morning? That's to say, are you a fan of breakfast in bed?
Hey, it's on. Turn it up. Turn it up.
Action News film critic Jane Muir. Jane?
Thanks, Sheila. I know I'll be riding my bike to the studio from now on. Viggo Mortensen and Gus Van Sant's Psycho, and Anne Bancroft and Alfonso Cuarón's Great Expectations. These are just two examples of what aspiring young filmmakers should take into account when setting out to recreate a classic cinematic experience. But for the unfortunate few moviegoers who will put themselves through first-time director Ian Lester's remake of Arthur Penn's Bonnie and Clyde, this is simply not the case. Lester has taken it upon himself to all but destroy what was once an American classic with this less than mediocre rendition.
The use of modern themes are usually the most intriguing aspect of a recreation, but they leave this film searching for an identity that never really made its way onto the set. For me, this film was like a limp game of cowboys and Indians. Whereas the violence in Penn's film is what gave the film its edge, this film's blatant attempt at a PG rating only bogs down the tumultuous love affair slash rampage of which this pair are all too famous for. Lester has basically handed in his movie-making resignation, despite having some of the most powerful connections in Hollywood and one of the hottest new agents to hit the scene in years. Lester has trotted out this garbled mess of a film as his debut. The one thing I did like about this film, however, was absolutely nothing. In fact, there should be special ratings for films that carry such low standards. This film should be rated G for garbage. No BOAs were given to this unequivocally disastrous film. Now, we move on to a delightful little romp through a pregnant teen's steamy romance with their OBGYN in Susan Stevens' masterpiece, Loss of Conscience. But first, a word from our sponsor.
Bitch, no. Man, I nailed that shit. Ian, what the fuck is going on? Wait here. I'll go take care of this.
Thank you.
Come on, come on.
Fuck.
Don't even ask, man. Don't even ask.
Come on, man. I'm 50 cents short of a fish sandwich, man.
Look, man, I told you. You know what? Wait right here.
Dude, what about my fish sandwich, man?
Here we go, man. One fish sandwich coming up.
Amen, mister.
So how was your day?
Pretty good, all things considered. Started the day off right. Had a nice long chat with Captain Morgan. Noontime, rolled around, had myself lunch with the King of Beds. And this evening, I get treated to a fish sandwich. Not too bad a day besides being broke and homeless.
You know, man, I see you out here probably every day. Most of the time, I thank God I'm not in your shoes.
He's just brand new.
And any other day, I'd feel you, but, after the kind of day I had, sitting around, drinking all day, begging for change, don't seem so bad.
What happened? You lose your cell phone?
Not only my entire future, today.
Sounds like you got a pretty good future in panhandling. You about whiny and needy as anybody I done met on the street.
Oh, come on, man. You just try having a day like I had. I dare you. Say, man, you got any change? Are you Matthew?
Matthew ain't gonna pick up, dude. He's a little tied up at the moment. Huh?
Oh, yeah, go ahead, man. The bottle's right over there.
I told you, dog. Skin Daddy got some little spot of trouble.
Fuck. Fuck you. Pick up.
Yo, look. This is the other end of your phone call.
What the fuck is going on? What am I looking at?
Room 527, Sir Francis Drake Hotel, time is the present.
Matthew? What's going on?
He can't see or hear you.
Okay, look, Rod Serling, what the fuck is going
on? Hey man, I'm trying to set you straight. Just cool out, and I'm gonna put you up on a lot of shit. See, you're probably asking yourself, why is this happening? What you need to be asking yourself is, how did my silly ass agent end up tied to a bed in room 527 of Sir Francis Drake Hotel when y'all should be popping off a bottle of Dom, fine French broad on your arm, getting ready to do a little ooh la la?
Yeah, but...
Nah, but nothing. Whereas once you was blind, now I'm gonna show you the light. Peep this. See, Matthew and Miss Muir had something going on. You heard of cyber sex, right? Well, the shit they was talking make HBO look like the WB. Yeah, but see, Skin Daddy had no idea he was cyber-fucking Miss Whale of a Time World Muir. Dumbass used his personal email address for that funky shit. Muir made the connection and bam, decided to raise the stakes on old boy. So we ended up here looking at some fool who done messed with the wrong bitch.
Story of my life.
Ian, I gotta hand it to you. Even now, it's still all about you getting fucked.
What are we watching now?
Bridge Theater. Time, present.
Hey, that's my girl. And my best friend.
Oh yeah, you mean John. Yeah, I'm about to show you that one too.
You should come down here and visit us more often. It gets quite lonely.
I would be pleased to come and visit you in your lovely office.
And maybe I can get you on the set. I know the director. He's kind of a tight ass, but once he sees how beautiful you are, he won't be able to resist.
That would be great. And then, afterwards?
You really can't blame him. A woman gives you an invitation like that,
no,
boy.
No, now I know this is bullshit. I heard what she was telling her friend about me just like last week.
D'accord. Je vais lui donner un essai. Je sortirai avec lui s'il me demande.
I don't know about you, but I studied French since high school. Let's hear this in English.
Why must I be careful in letting the boys know that I am interested? Is there something you're not telling me about? Is he married?
No. But we must keep the whole thing a secret.
A secret?
Yes, maybe you don't know this, but the weird one has a thing for you.
The weird one? Who is the weird one?
The weird one is Ian. And your cutie pie is John.
That son of a bitch!
I'm afraid High Five don't lie.
But he told me that he...
No, but nothing. He told you what you wanted to hear, man. How many times am I have to butt nothing? You recognize this. The sooner you wake up and get your head out your ass, the sooner we can get out of here. Now, do I have to show you your last girl taking it in the ass from your lightning instructor before you wake the fuck up?
No. I think I'm starting to get the point.
And you're here with me right now in the present. Look at her.
Come on, I saw her already, man. She's with him now.
Yeah, she with him. For the simple fact, she set it up like that. Reason being, she waiting for you. Well, anyway, man, I'm about to get back to my fist sandwich.
Hey, wait. What the fuck am I supposed to do now? No deal, no girl, no job, no girl, fuck!
At least you ain't got no dirty drawer stuff down your throat.
Yeah.
Look, Ian, me telling you shit's gonna be alright ain't gonna make it so. You need to take matters into your own hands. Now, I don't mean going upside nobody's head either. Yo, you be alright. You just needed a little bit of straightening out, that's all. And Lord knows I ain't had shit to do tonight. We need to be getting back anyways, yo.
I don't feel like I belong much anywhere right now.
You will.
Hello?
She fucked us. Ian, I'm sorry, man. That crazy bitch had it in for us from the beginning. I had no idea. You gotta believe me. Look, kid, don't worry. That crazy fucking bitch is gonna pay!
Thank you.
Say, any of you guys know what time it is?
Yeah, man, it's like 7 a.m.
What's this all about, anyway?
What you mean, no?
It's the next big thing. Curtis McDowell's the man! Yeah.
It's a bad, bad left behind. We're trapped in a devil mind. Let's break out with the wine. Give some of your bridges time. Give that girl a diamond ring. I knew every goddamn thing I had.
You haven't worked in months. There's a baby on the way.
I was supposed to be a boy named Thomas.
Putain, Jean! You are not even a man. You are dog shit!
It doesn't lose its flavor in cooking.
Just in. A startling discovery was made today at the home of Action News' own Jane Muir. Apparently, Ms. Muir has been the subject of a local kiddie porn sting operation, and today officers descended upon the alleged ringleader's home in Larkspur. We'll take you now to a live feed from the scene.
Thank you, Sheila. This is Jeremy Jankowitz reporting live from the residence of Jane Muir. Local law enforcement has placed her under arrest. Here they come. Miss Muir, do you have anything to say?
I'll get you for this, Cowboy 69.
Are you watching this, big guy? That lady really didn't know she was dealing with. Are you seeing this? Please tell me you're seeing this.
No, actually, I'm kind of busy at the moment. Well, hold on a sec. Thanks, baby. Well, let me call you later this evening.
Okay, hotshot. Hey, we should do lunch this week.
You got it. A power lunch, right? Oh, hey, and Matt, thank you for everything.
Oh, that reminds me. Kurt said not to forget his name in the credits.
Tell him to deal with it. I'm working. So?
Who is that?
Oh, that was Skinner.
Oh,
yeah? Yeah. He said something about that crazy critic. I guess she got caught with kiddie porn or something. Yeah, I swear to God.